I am Divyajyoti Ganguly, and I am currently pursuing my bachelor's in zoology honors. So, right, I come from West Bengal, where we have the fishing cat as our state animal. Madhubaka, one of the fishing cat's local names, literally means fish tiger. Called so because of the local perception of a small tiger-like cat pouncing on fish. And today, I'm going to talk about our work, Behaviour of the Fish Tiger in Human Youth Landscapes. So the other names, local names of the fishing cat include Bagrol, Mas Bagrol, Gobhaga in Bengal, and Baghari in Orissa. Fishing cat is protected under Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act. By the way, the fishing cat in Cambodia is known as Klap Tre, which also means fish tiger. So the fishing cat is distributed broadly from Pakistan in the west to Cambodia in the east. But the distribution, as we can see, is patchy, which is attributed to its close association to wetlands. The South Asian cohort of India, Nepal, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka, they hold the core of the fishing cat population. In India, fishing cats majorly are found along the Ganga, Yamuna and Brahmaputra floodplains, Sundarban Delta and other smaller coastal wetlands along the Bay of Bengal. In general, fishing cats majorly inhabit floodplains and deltas where emergent plant forms and the mangrove communities are the predominant vegetation. This is a typical fishing cat habitat. Now, out of 36 extant wild felid species, the fishing cat, the Prionaeolus viverinus, and the flat-headed cat, Prionaeolus laniceps, are the only wetland specialists. And this is significant given the recent and rapid evolution of felidae and strong similarities among its members in respect to morphology, physiology, and behavior. Now, in order to survive in wetland habitat, the fishing cat has evolved wetland adaptations like double-coated fur, which protects it from wetting effect of water, the semi-retractile claws gives traction and helps in fish hooking, there is partially wet paws, helps in swimming, and a short thick tail which acts as a rudder. Summarizing our introduction, the fishing cat is South Asia's only wetland specialist felid, and it primarily preys on fish. The objectives for this study were to analyze behavior associated to fish hunting in case of fishing cats, and to examine any shift in speak activity patterns with intensifying levels of human presence. So our study area consists of three sites. The one in red is Howrah from West Bengal. The one in orange is Paradip from Orissa. And the one in yellow is Chilka. So the Howrah district in West Bengal, it lies in the lower Gangetic floodplain and is drained by the Damodar and Rup Narayan rivers. Like the word Howrah originated from the Bengali word Hao, which also means low-lying wetlands. Now, once this place was very rich in marshy habitat, but rapid industrialization and urbanization has limited these into patchy islands, where we mainly concentrated our camera tripping exercise. So like in these islands, they form a matrix with ponds, which are small-scale aquaculture ponds, and agricultural plots. In Paradip, we conducted our study inside an industry complex, which is the phosphate power plant, where there is a contiguous reef patch of 9 square kilometers. Here, humans, they catch fish during the day near ponds, which are near the marshes, but thereafter human activity ceases. So Paradip is human used and modified, but Howrah was human used, modified and dominated. And in Chilka, our study site lies in the lake's northeast sector, where there's a contiguous reef patch of 115 square kilometers, which is crisscrossed by canals. And the locals, they catch fish during the day, and they catch a wild fish. And thereafter, human activity completely stops, like after sunset, it completely stops. So Chilka is only human use. So like while surveying the eastern coast of India till Orissa for the presence of fishing cats, our team carried out regular monitoring surveys in Howrah, Paradip and Chilka for searching for fishing cats. Like during those surveys, so we interacted with the locals and we provided camera traps to interested, enthusiastic students and community members under the Know Thy Neighbors Monitoring Initiative, which aims to help the locals monitor neighboring fishing catch. So we deployed, so 14 camera trucks were deployed starting from November 2016, mainly, like majorly along water bodies, but also along trails and near reefs to maximize fishing catch capture probability after locating scats and tracks. So soon we noticed that the data that we were getting, which was solely for the purpose of monitoring, was also revealing interesting behavioral data. So this motivated us to categorize the fish hunting behavior using simple ethograms, and to examine shift in activity pattern, we used scatter plots. Coming to the results, for analyzing fish hunting behavior, we used 81 videos. So like we analyzed a total of, took total of 96 videos, out of which 81 were used for this analysis. So here we can see that a state is any behavior which is of longer duration, and its salient feature is its duration. So from this table we can see that walking and standing, they constitute the major proportion of time spent by the fishing cat. So we can say that the fishing cat spends 87.5% of its time searching for prey. Coming to events, these are behavioral patterns of relatively shorter duration, and their salient feature are their frequency of occurrence. So here we can see that pheromone spray is behavior with maximum frequency, and out of the 6 attempts, only 4 attempts have been successful in this case. Let me describe one of the behaviors, like the behaviors one by one. So in walking by the pond behavior, the cat would be seen either walking by the pond or would be like standing by the pond, searching the pond intermittently for prey. In sitting by the pond behavior, it would sit patiently scanning the pond for prey. In stalking behavior, it would close in towards the pond's edge very carefully. And the pond's edge may or may not contain floating vegetation, but in this case, as we can see, there is some water hyacinth. And it would like very quietly move towards the pond's edge. In sniffing behavior, it would sniff the ground or air nearby or water body. Pheromone spraying, it would either raise its tail and spray pheromone on vegetation, or it would take a position which comes like somewhere between sitting and standing position, spray the pheromone and leave. Behavior with fish in mouth would be either seeing eating prey sitting by the pond bank or carrying prey away. In attempt to hunt behavior, after carefully stalking, it would jump inside, trying to catch prey, but in this case you can say it's unsuccessful. In defecating behavior, it would, after carefully sniffing the ground and selecting the spot, it would deposit its fecal matter. So this gives us the results for the first objective. Coming to the second, we use simple scatter plots, and as we can see, there is indeed some change in the activity pattern of fishing cat with increasing levels of human presence. So in case of Howrah, we can see that fishing cats are most active during the interval of 2 to 4 a.m. at night. In case of Paradeep, we can see there are two peaks. One peak comes between 8 to 10 and the other between 4 to 6. And in case of, one comes between 10 to 12 and the other comes between 4 to 6. And in case of Chilka, one comes between 8 to 10, and there is a minor peak as well, which comes between 2 to 4. Now these are results from unprotected area, which are somehow human use, all of them are human use. So now let's look at similar results from protected area. This was a study done in Budwa National Park at Katanya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary, where the green shows fishing cat. We can see that fishing cats do show some amount of diurnal behavior in protected areas. Coming to the discussion, since our study was completely based on data gathered from a monitoring initiative, so it lacks a particular design. And so the results are only indications of what the actual scenario could be. So our study indicates that the fishing cat spends most of its time searching for its prey, like almost 88% of its time. It takes limited attempts at hunt, and like all other predators, is not always successful at catching prey. This contradicts local perception that fishing cats visit their ponds every night and they empty fish ponds within days. On the contrary, we have recorded locals stealing fish during the at night from the local nearby ponds. But unfortunately, the fishermen always blame the fishing cats solely for all the losses. So we suggest that these observations should be taken under consideration while framing conflict mitigation strategies. And also, there's a need to quantify the hunting efficiency of the fishing cats so that real and perceived losses could be understood. We have observed territorial marking behavior such as pheromone spraying and defecation near water bodies, which are typical resource marking and territorial behavior in case of LED. And there is indeed a shift in activity patterns with intensifying levels of human presence. And we suggest that these might be because of them trying to co-inhabit with humans. And our study suggests that fishing cats might be using floating vegetation, which includes water hyacinth for stocking. Like all other non-pantherine felids, the fishing cat is no different. It acts as a very good rodent controller. Rodents are not only agricultural pests, but also flu spreaders, so we are benefiting from its predation. This is one of the first instances of social behavior between two fishing cats in the wild. From a previous study in the Netherlands Zoo, parental behavior was observed, and perhaps there are other interesting behavioral aspects which are yet to be studied. Fishing cats in general were quite unperturbed to the wide crash of camera traps. Although in Chilka, which is the least human use site, the fishing cats were a little shy at the beginning, but they didn't take much time to get adjusted. On the contrary, other sympatric species like jackals and otters got easily startled by the flash and fled the scene. A very worrying observation that we have made is the complete lack of otter captures from Howrah. Now this otter was once very common in Howrah. So like this, the absence of otter captures, which was like once common, and it's also not a specialist species from our record, suggests that the wetland health in these areas is rapidly decreasing, and this could also affect the fishing cats in the long run. I'd like to thank our team and collaborators, which include members of Modai Neighbors Initiatives. We have the Fishing Cat Protection Committee, amongst whom is Lalu Maiti, who is an active participant in collection of camera traps footages. I'd like to thank students from the Phosphate Power Plant of Paradeep, Wild Orissa for giving logistical support, Mahavir Pakshi Suraksha Samiti, Association for Social and Environmental Development, and special thanks goes to Iramati. She's an alumnus from NCBS for helping us thoroughly with the analysis of our work. We're supported by Mohamed bin Zayed Species Conservation Fund, Wildlife Trust of India, Wildlife Conservation Trust, and Small Wild Cat Conservation Foundation. Thank you all on behalf of the Fishing Cat Project.
Thank you, Divyajyoti. Maybe one question? Yeah, one and two.
Don't you think that apart from human behavior in a protected area, there might be other factors which can affect activity pattern of rescue areas, fishing and like large predators?
Yeah,
how
exactly.
Can you compare these things?
So like what we did in this particular study from Lutwa, they saw that they inferred that fishing cats are trying to avoid the large predators like tigers and leopards. So like they are adopting a kind of diurnal behavior. But what we are trying to do is, since there are no human presence in that particular protected area, so we are comparing it with places which have human presence. So we are like using it as a control. So we are not saying that humans, if they are absent, fishing cats will become diurnal. But we are just trying to indicate that fishing cats do show some diurnal behavior in protected areas, but they are mostly like nocturnal in human use landscapes.
Thank you.